IVM.
Did you know that your energy intake shouldn't just be from carbs? It should also include good fats and proteins. And this is something that the Whole Truth has taken to heart in order to provide you with a balanced breakfast option called the Perfect Breakfast. This is a range of delicious muesli that comes in three flavors: nuts, fruits, and seeds, quinoa choco crunch, and almond choco crunch. When you eat this muesli, only 50% of your energy comes from carbs. The rest is from all natural good fats and proteins. Just visit thewholetruthfoods.com and use the coupon code HABIT on checkout to get an awesome 20% discount. Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach Podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashton Doctor, your Habit Coach. And today's not so fun fact of the day has to do with heartbreak. Did you know that heartbreak is actually a real thing? There's a condition called Takotsubo cardiomyopathy, and I'm sure I completely murdered that name. But it is caused by a heartbreaking kind of situation, where stress all of a sudden shocks and paralyzes the left ventricle of the heart. Hence, the heart can't function properly. This feels like having a heart attack, but luckily the effect is only temporary. But what is fascinating is how the body has a physical reaction to something so emotional as a heartbreak. The whole interplay of hormones at this point of time is so interesting. For example, when you have those butterflies in your stomach, you're predominantly fueled by dopamine, the pleasure or seeking hormone, where you're looking out for your next interaction with your lover. You feel great, like you're on top of the world. Then, when you end things with that person, your body is in a state of stress. This stress is predominantly cortisol. And cortisol over a period of time can lead to anxiety, nausea, weight gain, basically all those symptoms that we associate with heartbreak. The strange thing is that heartbreak pains us physically. It pains us in our body. The feeling of someone reaching out and ripping your heart out is real. The feeling of being unable to breathe is real. And then comes the crying. The days and weeks of crying. While tears are one way of getting cortisol out of your body, it is not enough. You feel like this is the worst day of your life and you can never feel normal again. You wait to feel normal. Wish it will happen. But the pain continues. Yesterday, I was doing a Q&A session on Instagram, and about four people had a discussion with me about heartbreak. Many had their hearts broken a decade ago and have not healed from it. They carry that pain as a shield with them wherever they go. That one experience has scarred them and scared them so much that they never want to experience it again. They want to stay away from love and romance and relationships as much as possible. I have been hurt once and I will never make that same mistake again, is what they say. And that's like burning your fingers while cooking once and then swearing never to cook again or use fire again. But the truth is, you need to know how to never make that particular mistake again. Learn from the mistake and continue cooking. Who knows, you might make the best dish of your life next. And as your habit coach, I want you to experience life and love fully. Love is a beautiful thing, but you need to do two things if you want to heal from the past heartbreak. The first is to put your shield down and realize that not everyone is your enemy trying to hurt you. The person in your past hurt you, yes. That does not mean the next person will too. You have to stop seeing everyone as your ex because they are not. What is worse is that you are judging someone even before you have gotten to know them, judging and stereotyping them from the past. And that is extremely unfair. You have to lower your shield and be open. Be cautious if you must, but no shields of the past pain are allowed. The second thing you need to do is heal from the past. Think of yourself as being physically cut or wounded from the past relationship. If you didn't heal from that, you would bleed over anyone else who came into your life. And when I mean bleed on, I mean you will lash out at them, treat them badly. And this again is very unfair to that person that will come into your life. He is not the one who hurt you. You have to put in the work, you have to put in the effort to heal and to trust again. Relationships are amazing. Love is amazing. And that feeling of being connected with someone is amazing. I know you're going through pain right now, but it does not always have to be so. You need to learn to love again. The best way I know how to do this is to give love and not expect it back in return, because expectation leads to pain. If you're scared of pain, don't have an expectation. Instead, just give love. Give love, give love, give love. Like I said in the podcast before, it is strange, but the more love you give, the better you feel. So your simple habit starts by focusing on healing yourself of the past pain. Every day, shed the baggage you hold. Every day, let go of that painful memory. Every day, slowly allow yourself to feel again. Then, lower your shield of pain. I hope someday you put it down altogether and walk free and unencumbered by the pain. But more importantly, I hope you love again. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashton Doc on Twitter and Instagram. You can find lots more information on my website, awesome180.com, or check out different content on my YouTube channel called AWESOME180. That's Awesome180. Did you know that you can now stand a chance to win some incredible prizes with the Cred app? You really can. Just pay your credit card bills on Cred and you can win some kick-ass rewards, prizes and cashbacks. Tons of cool stuff to be won every day, so don't miss out. Just download Cred.
I hope you enjoyed that show. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week, Cred, Cied, thewholetruthfoods.com, and PayPal. We really appreciate your support. So this week on Cyrus Says, Cyrus had some interesting guests. Kayo Zarani was on to talk about his new Netflix film. And Mayur Tekchandani has made a new coffee table book about the city of Mumbai, which he came to discuss on the show. On The Wire Talk, Siddharth Bhatia was joined by Dr. Ali Khan Mahmoodabad to talk about the Muslim community's issues during these thorny times. On The Habit Coach, Ashton Doctor is joined by Sonia Jaz to talk about the importance of fitness and why this is a great time to begin a journey to good health. The Simplified Gang has reunited and they discuss the hue and cry around the European Super League that was eventually just dropped after 2 days. On Shunya One, Shilith and I are talking to Gurubhat from PayPal India. We talk about fintech, the future of digital payments, and a whole lot more. Really, really deep and interesting conversation about PayPal, its plans in India, and what kind of hiring they're looking to do. On The Millennial Athlete, Tanvi and Shlok were joined by sport and performance psychologist Dr. Sri Advani to talk about mental health for young sports stars. And I just want to again mention some of our cricket shows. You should definitely check out Edges and Sledges. And we also have a Hindi show called Khel Niti. Do check that out as well. And with that, we hope to see you again next week.